Hey guys, welcome back to Bernard from the BTNHD, and yes, the top 10 Windows 10 Spring 2020 update features that Microsoft is going to push out to us. And yeah, let's get started. All right, so I am Bernardo from the BTNHD, and we're going to go over the top 10 features that I like or I've seen within the Windows Insider Preview. Microsoft likes to push it out to the Insider Preview first, and then I'm going to roll it out to the public pretty soon. Now, before I do anything, inside my desktop, I'm going to right-click on the Start menu, go to Run, type in WinVER, hit OK. And the current Insider build that I have right now is build 19.564, okay? Hopefully, I think by next week, they're going to have another build with more crazy updates. So number one is control over optional updates. This is a pretty cool feature. Now, the majority of these new features are actually housed inside the settings app, right? It's crazy. So within the option to control your, optional stuff, if you go inside settings and you go inside updates and security, and within Windows updates, you're going to see an option that says view optional updates. When you click on it, you're going to see this. If you click on driver update, you have a list of what you could tell Windows 10, like, hey, I want you to update these drivers for me. Next one in my list is cloud download. This is a nice little feature within the settings app. You go inside updates and security, you go to recovery. If you click on gig started within the reset this PC section and you remove everything, it gives you an option to download the Windows 10 operating system from the cloud. I think I did a video for you guys when I ran a test between the cloud and the local install. I think the test was like, it wasn't too crazy with the cloud. You're able to grab the image within the cloud, push it down, install it, and then good to go. That process is actually seen within the Mac world. You are able to deploy the operating system within the, an internet recovery, which is pretty cool. Now, next one in my list is limit bandwidth for updates. This is huge, especially if you're a gamer. You do not want to have big updates to be pushed behind the scenes when you're gaming. So again, within the settings app, updates and security, if you go inside delivery optimization, you're going to see an option that says advanced options. So when you click on it, it gives you a crap load of options that allows you to configure the bandwidth for Windows updates. Right. Next one in my list is faster Windows index search. Right. Again, within the Windows settings app, if you go to search and then you go inside searching Windows, you're going to see that it gives you two types of ways to search or index the files within your, within your desktop. Right now, I have to turn it off because when it's indexing large files, it grabs a lot of CPU and memory. I don't want that. You are able to tell the machine to not scan this particular folder, to relieve some of the resources that this guy actually takes within your machine. Next one in my list is type of disk. This is kind of like a stupid little feature, but I kind of like it. Within the task manager, your C drive, D drive, or whatever partition that you have, it tells you what type is it. Is it a solid state drive or a hard disk drive? I think that's pretty cool. One that I have not added within this list is if you have a graphics card, it actually tells you the temperature within Task Manager. That's a pretty cool feature that Windows 10 has. Another one is rename virtual desktops. If you use virtual desktops, I believe this kind of feature has been seen within the Mac world. Windows 10 kind of stole it. Yeah, Microsoft, yeah, you stole it. When you create desktops, it just calls it desktop one, desktop two, new desktop, blah, blah, blah. You're able to click on it and then rename them to whatever you want. Next one on my list is the network status information. From here, if you go inside settings app, network and internet, and you will see a nice little network status. It tells you like the bandwidth that you've used within your Wi-Fi or within your Ethernet. That's pretty cool. Control over restarting apps. This is a nice little kind of feature. If you go inside accounts, sign-in options, you're able to turn it on. So if your machine shuts off or you have Chrome open, it will restart it for you. Again, that's one of the features that I've seen within the Mac world. Header information, if you open up the settings app, You would see your name, information such as when Windows updates were last checked. If you're logged into OneDrive, you also see that information there. Next nice little feature that Windows 10 is going to be pushing out pretty soon is uninstall option features. If you go inside apps, and within apps, you will see optional features. When you go in there, you are able to now remove Microsoft Paint and also Microsoft WordPad and Notepad if you want to free up some space. Last but not least in my list is the text cursor indicator. If you go inside the ease of access and then you go inside, text cursor, you're able to modify how large the cursor is or the color. It's a pretty cool feature. And that's it, guys. That is my top 10 plus new features that the Windows or Microsoft is going to be pushing out for spring 2020 updates for Windows 10. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button. Also subscribe and share out the video, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.